You will hear from President of the AIIB, Jinli Chun, from ministers to the multilateral institution and our growing membership. Prime Minister, we look forward very much to hearing what you have to say.
With committed capital of $100 billion and huge need for infrastructure in member countries, I take this opportunity to call upon AIIB to expand from financing $4 billion to $40 billion by 2020 and $100 billion by 2025. This will require simpler processing. Our macroeconomic fundamentals are strong with stable prices as robust external sector and a fiscal situation firmly in control. Despite rising oil prices, inflation is within the mandated range. The government is firmly committed to the path of fiscal consolidation. Government debt as percentage of GDP is consistently declining. India has achieved a rating upgrade after a long wait. The external sector remains robust. Our friends, the Indian story of economic resurgence closely mirrors that of many other parts of Asia. Now, the continent finds itself at the center of the global economic activity. It has become the main growth engine of the world. In fact, we are now living through what many have termed the Asian century.
Distinguished governors and members of the board of directors, honored guests, later with Morgan Stanley as the fund manager, through this
looking at the prospects for developing Asia, I will ask, will we continue to have an open global trading system, or will the world retreat into protectionism? I would urge some developed countries to resist protectionism and remain open, and developing countries to continue opening up. We must strive to preserve those features which spread benefits, and we must rejuvenate and rethink those systems which may be weakening to find a path forward in the 21st century, the Asian century. We must also revitalize the global economic institutions.